got friendly, holding my hand. Well, she got friendly down in the sand.
Olivia Newton John captured our hearts as Sandy in Greece, and she also set an example of strength. She battled breast cancer for more than 3 decades.
And she became an outspoken advocate for awareness about the disease. KCAL9's Amy Johnson joins us now with a closer look at Newton John's long journey in her battle against breast cancer. Amy.
Well, Leslie and Susie, 1 in 8 women will be diagnosed with breast cancer, but less than 3% of women will die from the disease. Olivia Newton-John battled breast cancer on and off for 30 years, and while her situation is rare, it is a reminder of how devastating the disease can be.
Tell me about it, Stan.
Word of Olivia Newton-John's death came as a shock to most, despite her 3 battles with breast cancer over nearly 30 years.
It's uncommon once you get beyond a 5-year time point.
We spoke with Dr. Jason McKellop, the medical director of breast imaging for RadNet of Southern California via Zoom. He did not treat the singer and actress who revealed her first cancer diagnosis in 1992. She was treated with a partial mastectomy, chemotherapy, and breast reconstruction.
Of all breast cancers, there's less than 20% risk of a recurrence occurring after 5 years.
McKellop says the chance of recurrence of the cancer after 10 years has an even more significant drop. But Newton-John's cancer returned more than 20 years later in 2013 as a tumor in her shoulder.
And that's the real frustrating thing about cancers in general, is that they exist on a microscopic, if not cellular, level, and they may still yet have the ability to move around or metastasize without our knowing it clinically.
Sadly, her cancer would return yet again in 2017 as a tumor at the base of her spine and would ultimately take her life. According to the American Cancer Society, there is only a 2.6% chance that a woman will die from breast cancer.
There is no cure for breast cancer. Mammograms, screening mammograms, are the best way that we currently know how to do that. And I would encourage all women to begin screening mammography at age 40 and to continue to do so on an annual basis thereafter.
And again, screening is key, along with self-exams, because as Dr. McKellop said, there is no cure, just treatment if it's caught early enough. I'll send it back to you, ladies.
All right, Amy, thank you so much.